Good morning, everyone. Thanks so much for joining today's session with PTC. Today's session will be presented by Sohail. At the end of the session, if you have any questions, please mention them in the Q&A tab on your left. The questions will be answered towards the end of the session. Sohail, over to you, please. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Chanakya, for the introduction. And good morning, everyone. My name is Sohail, and I am the principal consultant at Redington Gulf. And today I would be talking to you about what does ThingsWorx as a platform from PTC. Okay, so the agenda of the today's discussion will be like I will be discussing what PTC is all about as a company. Then next one will be moving forward to the ThingsWorx platform, like what is ThingsWorx as a platform and how it can help industries to unlock the digital potential that they have. And finally, at the end, I'll be showing use some screenshots of the dashboards that have been created using the ThingsWorx platform for managing your assets. Okay, so let's start. So talking about PTC, PTC was established in the year 1985, and they are headquartered in Boston, Massachusetts, with a strong workforce of 6,000 employees, and they are present across 30 countries around the world. And they also have a strong partner ecosystem. As you can see, at the moment, they have like more than 1,000 partners as the technology partners in the current ecosystem. And the revenue that they have generated is almost more than $1 billion. So this actually speaks for itself. They have been operating across various verticals, as it is evident from this slide. Like, they have been working in the industrial product, electronics and high tech, aerospace, defense, automotive, sector, retail, consumer. No matter what sector you have, they have their presence across all verticals. Moving forward, PTC, they have been recognized by leading analyst firms as a leader in the industrial IoT software platform. Like, they have been ranked as a leader in the Forrester Research. They have been ranked as visionary by the Gartner. They have been ranked in the top four by the IDC MarketScape. So as you can see over here, I mean, they have been rated quite highly by various analyst firms that you have out there in the corporate market. So moving forward, this actually gives you a revenue that it generates in the IoT sector. The PTC as a company, they actually operate in various areas like the CAD, computer-aided design, the PLM, the product lifecycle management, IoT, and the augmented reality stuff. So they, if you look at the PTC financial performance, okay, in terms of the IoT and the augmented reality, like, they have been able to register 141 million annual recurring revenue business, and they are the only one who came out in the market, and they are openly putting out their revenue in terms of the IoT that has been generated. I mean, I can be sure that there has been no other company that has put forward their IoT based revenues. I mean, PTC is the only one that have done that. Okay, so as you can see here, PTC actually that concentrates on converging the physical world with the digital world. Okay, by physical world, what I mean is that you have your assets, you have your entities, you have your smart cities and your factories, your medical equipments. The data is generated. I mean, this is the data that is actually generated from the physical world. Now, the data that is generated from this physical world is actually passed on to the digital world or the digital platforms, wherein you can analyze your data. You can mash up your data, you can detect the patterns in your data, and it actually helps you create an ecosystem of value. So moving forward, PTC, they have a strong technology platform. Like, they have platform from the three-dimensional modeling, Then they have some for the product lifecycle management. Then the industrial IoT platform that we will be talking about. And then the experience, the augmented reality and the virtual reality experience that they have. Okay. So moving forward, like things work, like I'll be discussing what things work is all about. Okay. As you can see in here, like things work, they it's all about the digital content management, remote access, then defining your business process flows, connecting to various data sources that you have in your landscape. Okay, now moving on to the digital transformation. Like digital transformation has been quite long in the corporate space. But we need to realize, like, has the digital transformation been successfully implemented? And what is this digital transformation? Does digital transformation means only technology, or it means something else? I would say that digital transformation is actually a combination of your people, products, and processes, wherein you are interconnecting them into a single ecosystem. Okay. By having your products smart connected, then you have your smart connected people, then smart connected processes. By creating this kind of ecosystem, I mean, you are able to make workforce productivity and quality soar, enable breakthrough in operational effectiveness, and drive critical product and service differentiation. Now looking at the PTC digital transformation solution suite, like as we were discussing in the previous slide, I mean they have three dimensional modeling. Then they have the Windchill for the product lifecycle management, things work as an IoT platform, and the Vuforia for the augmented reality. The key benefits that you have with the PTC's digital transformation solution suite is that it actually helps you drive business impact quickly. It accelerates your application deployment. You do not need to waste like 3 months, 6 months of time with deploying your application. When a lot of application that comes from PTC ThingsWorx platform is just plug and play. It also helps you adapt to new business context to competitive in the market. Some of the solutions that transform the industrial enterprise are like the service optimization, engineering excellence, manufacturing efficiency, product and service innovations. Again, the core part of these solutions are your products that you have in your ecosystem, are your people, the workforce, and your processes that you define. Now, what is ThingsWorx as a platform? Now, that is the most interesting part. ThingsWorx as a platform is a leading industrial IoT platform that enables you to create countless solutions for your smart connected products and smart connected operations and setting like factories, healthcare, oil and gas, and the most important being like in the today's time, it's actually the smart cities. It allows you to unlock the value in the convergence of the physical and the digital world. As we had seen in the previous slides, how this happens, the convergence between the physical and the digital world. Now, why ThingsWorx? I mean, you have multiple IoT platforms out there in the market, but why ThingsWorx? Okay. So, as you can see, it actually it actually enables your workforce for the rapid development, deployment, and extensibility of the apps that you create using this platform. Okay. And the specific functionality, it has a specific functionality designed for industrial IoT, including your connectivity, scalability, and security to grow with your business. So when you talk of connectivity, I mean, there is no limitation to it. I mean, no matter what kind of devices you have or edge devices, whatever it is, I mean, you can integrate those devices to your ThingsWorx platform and create a mashup of that data and derive value out of that data. It also enables, it actually gives you a good engaging experience. I mean, the users with the drag and drop tools can deploy them to the web and the mobile applications. Okay, now let's look at the ThingsWorx product portfolio that they have. I mean, the ThingsWorx, it's actually divided into three major components. As you can see, some first thing is the ThingsWorx industrial connectivity. They have the with this, they have the largest library of drivers and protocols for connectivity. So I mean, it can connect to 150 plus different assets, 150 different assets from the companies. Okay, no matter what assets you have, it can connect to that. I mean, suppose you're having an hardware, okay, within an industry or in a factory that needs to be connected to the ThingsWorx platform to analyze your IoT data. So what happens is that you have this custom-made SDKs that enables you to connect your assets to your ThingsWorx platform. And how that can be done, I'll be showing you forward in the slides. Then there's something called as ThingsWorx Foundation. This is a platform for developing your applications, okay, wherein you can develop your mobile applications, you can your web applications. So it is something, it's actually a platform that is enabling you to develop the applications. It's enabling you to give a good view of your data. Then you have something called as the ThingsWorx Analytics. So they actually, with the ThingsWorx Analytics, it provides you with more scalable analytics. You can form the kind of analytics that you want to do, like whether it be prescriptive, descriptive, operative, no matter what kind of analytics you want, you are capable of doing that. By this, the advantage that you have is that you do not need to integrate your IoT platform from with third-party analytics tool like Power BI, Tableau, SAP, or MicroStrategy. This is one of the benefits that you have with it in terms of the ThingsWorx analytics that is embedded in this portfolio. Then you also have this pre-built app. Like when you get the ThingsWorx platform, okay, you have pre-built apps that are within. Some of those apps as are like ThingsWorx Control Advisor, Asset Advisor, Production Advisor, Operator Advisor, and Navigate. So what this the basic function of this apps are defined in the next slide. As you can see over here, the Operator Advisor is basically a role-based read-write application enabled by real-time connectivity and augmented reality to improve operator quality and the productivity. Now coming to the ThingsWorx Production Advisor, it actually gives you real-time visibility and insights into the production line performance and status. Then you have the Control Advisor. With this, you are enabled to remotely monitor and troubleshoot machine connectivity. So just look how it will enable your workforce to derive the value, to save the time. So by saving the time, what I mean to say is that, I mean, you do not need to recreate this apps once you buy the platform, like, or you have this platform in your place. You do not need to recreate the app when you have already custom built apps over here. So just see how, just imagine how it empowers your workforce, how it saves your time, how it increases your productivity. I mean, that is the requirement of the time right now. So how ThingsWorx empower industry? ThingsWorx basically empowers industrial business to actually connect to the disparate data sources. They actually or help you build a complete industrial IoT solution and an augmented reality experience. Then coming on, moving forward, they help you analyze your IoT data for the real-time insights, predictions, and recommendations. And one of the most important thing is that you are able to manage the performance of your devices that are connected to your IoT platform. That is a big advantage that you have. Then obviously the experience that you have with this platform, it basically rapidly builds engaging and compelling visual cross devices user experiences. Now let's look at the platform architecture from a bird eye view. Okay, then we'll go in more detail. Okay, so suppose this is your existing landscape. Okay, at the bottom you have your IT systems, your assets, your external data feed. On top of that, you can have your Azure cloud services, Okay, or also you can have this deployed on premises. Okay, then you have your ThingsWorx platform, wherein you are able to connect, build, analyze, manage, and experience. Then you have the custom build apps that we discovered. Then we have the solutions that can be implemented with these apps, like the engineering excellence, the service optimization, product and service innovation, manufacturing efficiency, sales and marketing. Digging down a deep more on this industrial IoT platform. Yeah. So now coming on this slide, if you look at the bottom, when you are able to connect to any data sources that you have within your factory, within industry, as you can see, I mean, they have a communication platform with the industry connectivity. Then you have the edge. You can connect to the edge devices. You throw the SDK and the IoT gateways. Then you have the data drivers to connect your data sources. Okay. Then you have the then you have the cloud stage, wherein your identity and access management are defined. You have your cloud adapters. Then you also define the big data and the rules engine and how the file transfer and messaging and the tunneling. Tunneling is more of a security concept. Now, coming to the application enablement. I mean, this area is also called as thing model. I mean, this is one of the most important areas in the ThingsWorx platform, wherein you are actually defining your business logic, how the events will be processed. Okay. You are building an interface for your user. You are doing basic analytics on it. Okay. And you also can do the visual application modeling. Then on the top, you have this device management, as you can see over here, wherein you are managing your assets, you are managing your alerts, you are managing the software content, and you are managing your workflow. The thing model that you see over here, it's actually the key. While you can use disparate parts from various manufacturers, the beauty of thing model is that it basically allows you to seamlessly tie in all of these components into one. Okay. Another benefit that you have is with this thing model is that it actually helps you to increase development velocity and deliver easier to maintain solutions. It also helps you impose the data model for the application that you are going to create. Make device and inter-system connectivity easy, and also connects and power all other IT platform tools. Okay. So now let's look at the architecture, how it looks like. I mean, this is one of the most important areas which can help you give a brief overview of the architecture from the technical perspective. Excuse me. On the left that you see, you have your assets. Okay, you have your data coming from the CAD, the computer aided design, the product lifecycle management, or you have your data coming from industries, from sensors, or from your controllers, the PLC controllers. Then you have your data coming from various assets, like be it washing machine, be it a traffic light, be it a truck, or any moving vehicle, like your assets. This in turn is actually connected to a ThingsWorx server that is responsible for managing all the incoming connections from various assets. Okay. From here, ThingsWorx connection is the foundation, is actually the foundation that actually processes the data from your assets to the ThingsWorx foundation layer. So what is ThingsWorx foundation layer? ThingsWorx foundation layer, as we discussed in the previous slide, it's actually a combination, or it's the main part of the ThingsWorx foundation is the thing model. Okay. Wherein you are able to analyze your data, you can model your data. You define the business logic, Okay, then you have the persistence provider, the databases like PostgreSQL, MSSQL, InfluxDB, Azure SQL. This all combine to form a thing model. Then you have something called as ThingWorx Mashup Builder. I mean, this is an area where you can build your dashboards. Okay, dashboards on top of the data that you have defined, on top of the model that you have defined using the ThingWorx Composer. Then obviously you have the ThingWorx Analytics, where you can implement machine learning algorithms. You can use artificial intelligence to study how the data is moving across the platform and do a predictive maintenance. Then you have something called as Vuforia Studio, that is more of an augmented reality and the virtual reality platform. So if we break down the architecture, as I was talking, on the left-hand side that you see is actually the things and the devices that enables you to connect your things, devices, assets to the ThingWorx platform. Then you have the user and the clients that are connecting to the platform. At the application layer, the heart of the application layer is the ThingWorx platform. Okay, so in this layer, you have the content from devices that is ingested. Requests from users are answered, and the content is analyzed to generate alerts. Now, if you remember previously, we were talking about a brief overview of the ThingWorx platform, wherein you can connect, you can manage your experience, the good experience. So we'll discuss in more detail about all this stuff. Connect. Now, if you look at this, the connect option that this platform provides us, okay, you can connect to any of the industry's leading platform. Okay, I mean, you can have it enabled. You can have a direct connection to it. You can have your sensors embedded into your assets. Okay, then the ThingWorx KPI server that you see over here in this particular slide, this actually enables you to connect to more than 150 plus different industrial assets. As you can see over here, offers a library of 150 plus devices and client drivers and advanced plugin. Okay, and this has been consistently awarded and validated by the leading industry group, the ThingWorx KPI server. This is specifically to the industries and the factories. Now moving on, there has been a lot of complexity. Like if you see the industries and the factories, I mean, you have a lot of complexity that is there in their ecosystem. Okay, as industries modernize, they consistently encounter the following obstacles. As you can see here, connectivity to various devices, the data quality and the quantity that is generated. I mean, the speed at which the data is generated is quite huge right now. Then you have the system security, you have the usability, then you have something called as then the constantly changing technology. How can this be solved? So here comes the ThingWorx server. ThingWorx KPI server, this actually centralizes all the incoming connection, create a single platform for you. I mean, you do not need to manage your multiple connections. You just have one server, ThingWorx KPI server, which actually enables you to connect your all your assets within your industries or your production flow. So how this can be done is that this can be done through using ThingWorx Edge SDKs. I mean, you can secure your connection. The benefits that you have with ThingWorx Edge SDKs are like the secure connection, the compression, the file transfer, then you have the offline message store, then you have the tunneling, you have the proxy settings in there. Now, coming to the build, this is the most important thing, the build aspect, because this is the place wherein you are designing your model, okay, designing your model of how your application will look like. You are defining the business terminologies in here, you are interconnecting the devices, okay, and you are defining the properties. Let's move forward with this. Okay, things that you see on the left hand side of the screen, they are basically your assets, and those are considered to be things. Now these assets or the things that you have, they have got various properties defined for it. Then you have the services, events and subscriptions. Okay, then you have, for example, if you see in here, let's take the example, taking the example of the washing machine, you have the properties like the running hours, the water temperature, the soil level, the load size. Then for the services aspect, you have something called like check wash, update firmware, report failure. Then in terms of the event, you have something called as wash complete, wash started, dry started. Then the subscription, wherein it actually notifies you. Fine. Then you also can have the data coming in from the enterprise system, from the services, from the finances, from the engineering or the sales system. Okay. So how it actually performs is that it basically first evaluates, okay, whether the services are working fine or not. Okay. If the services are not working fine or an event is triggered, okay, for example, if you have this, if a trigger is defined, say that stop dishwater if the all the glasses have been washed. So event is it's actually triggered to stop the dishwasher. Then you have the subscription. You can see how the data is being moved from the services to the event to the subscription. Now coming to the analyze part. Okay. Analyze is actually quite broad term. I mean, a lot of products out there in the market provide you with the analytical capabilities, like you have Power BI, you have Tableau, you have Qlik. But what is the benefit that you have with the ThingsWorx? Okay. So talking in terms of the analytical capabilities, it basically requires different level of human input to take action. Something like what happened, why did it happen? When this is what the standard tools provide, the benefit that you have with this platform, the ThingsWorx analytics platform, okay, it actually helps you to say what will happen and what should I do to stop this happening. I mean, that is the most important thing right now, having a predictive maintenance and a prescriptive maintenance of your assets. So it actually provides you with the complete industrial IoT platform capabilities, wherein you can define your descriptive services, you can perform machine learning modeling, then you can pre-built simulation. It actually also provides you with the pre-built simulation provider integration, and it provides you with the simulation model included in the digital twin. Okay, you have some of the inbuilt calculations. I mean, there's no need for you to define a calculation from the start. You have various statistical calculations within the ThingsWorx, like you have this average, median, data distribution, sampling frequency. Okay. Moving forward. These platform, it enables you to find patterns in your data. The hidden patterns in your data. Okay, so by hidden patterns, what you can know is that it actually helps you to understand how your machine is performing. Are there any anomalies that have been detected? Is the performance of the machine is varying? If yes, then you can take a prescriptive action based on that data. This is what I was talking about, the predictive analytics. I mean, you can analyze the machine pattern. You can predict the failure rate, at what percentage, okay, what is the probability of the error, and what date and time this asset is about to fail. I mean, you can have this predictive analytics built within the ThingsWorx platform. Okay. Now, the manage. Coming to the manage aspect of the ThingsWorx platform, okay. Using this ThingsWorx platform, there's something called as ThingsWorx Flow, a component between the ThingsWorx platform wherein you are able to connect to more than 50 plus applications, like whether be it Office 365, whether it be SAP ERP, Dynamic Cloud, Salesforce. I mean, you can actually connect to that. So ThingsWorx provide you with, as I was talking previously, they provide you with a library of connectors, like more than 50 plus. How it basically works is that, suppose you have an alert that is being generated and you want to notify it to the end user, or you want to create a ticket for that. So what ThingsWorx Flow does is that once a trigger is alerted, okay, once you subscribe to the connected device alert to trigger a flow, what will happen is that the ThingsWorx platform will look up for the information that the device generates. Okay, next what it does is that once it has the information with regards to the alert that has been generated by the asset, okay, what it will do is that it will create a case, it will create a ticket within the Salesforce. Okay, then once the ticket is created, you can schedule a service for this with your technicians, and the technicians can be notified of this issue through the email. Okay, then you can send a text to the operator to shut it down, okay, till you have your technician on the ground to fix this issue. As I was telling previously, they provide 50 enterprise system connected that is ready to use out of the box. When you can connect to SAP, Salesforce, Windchill, Dynamics 365, Office 365, no matter what application you have, you can actually connect to that. They also provide you with the standard connectivity, the standard connectors like HTTP, OData, ODBC, SQL. Okay. So moving on, what is the customer value realization with the ThingsWorx Flow? So it actually enables more role with less skills, and you can build more apps more quickly. Okay, and that is the most valuable thing that you have is can increase the time frame. I mean, not the time frame. You can decrease the time frame and increase the number of apps that you can create using this platform. Now, speaking of the experience, there is something called as things within the platform. If you remember when we were talking about the ThingsWorx architecture, there was something called as ThingsWorx Mashup Builder. So within this ThingsWorx Mashup Builder, what you this platform actually enables you to create dashboards on top of the data or top of the model that you had defined. And you actually, you do not define any business rules in here. All the business rules were defined in the thing model that we had seen previously. Okay, so the Mashup Builder is basically what you see is what you get. Okay, you just need to drag and drop the items onto your canvas, connect your items in the canvas with the data and start working. It's as simple as that. When you have got various widgets in there, in this ThingsWorx platform, like 60, 65 plus widgets, 65 plus out of the box widgets, okay? You just need to drag and drop onto the canvas to quickly create powerful IoT solutions. Just see how it is empowering your workers, no matter if you're a person with a low technical, a less technical background, even you can create dashboards on top of your data using this platform. If you had been if you had deployed other analytic tools like Power BI, Tableau or something other, you need to learn the language of these tools. But with this platform, no, there's no need of that. ThingsWorx Mashup Builder is basically what you see is what you get. It also has a responsive layout, okay? No matter what size of the screen that you're using it, no matter what screen resolution you're using, it will automatically adjust to that. Then you have the theme editor. You can adjust the theme of the dashboards that you are creating within your organization. Okay. You can actually control how it appears these are the sample dashboards from the ThingsWorx. I'll be showing a more sample dashboard screenshots of those. I mean, how they look. I mean, how you can control your access from the dashboards. Okay, now coming to the building maintenance dashboard. As I was talking previously, I'll be showing you some sample dashboard. If you look at this, this is a dashboard that's being developed using the ThingsWorx platform. I mean, the ThingsWorx Mashup Builder. ThingsWorx platform is a whole, and within the ThingsWorx platform, you have something called as Mashup Builder. Over here, you can see that you have got various buildings. Okay, I have got my assets connected in here. So what I'm able to see is that for this particular building, I'm able to see what is my monthly energy consumption, what is the cost, and how many average service calls per month I'm getting for this from this particular building, and what are the active service alerts. Okay, I mean, if I scroll down to some other building, I can look the value for that. Now, if I want to compare it with the overall score, for example, let's take this 143. I need to compare this particular building with my overall score, with the average score, how it looks like. Okay, this is how it looks. It is actually giving you the building efficiency score. What are the service tickets? What are the energy costs? What is the energy efficiency ratio? And then the service cost, energy consumption, total monthly consumption. Okay, and what areas the tickets have been served. All this is coming from the data model that you define in the ThingsWorx platform. And this dashboard, again, I'm reiterating this, this dashboard has been developed in using the ThingsWorx Mashup Builder. Now coming to the next part, you can also have a bird eye view or a detailed view about the equipments that you have within your building. I mean, for example, the rooftop heat pump, the rooftop air condenser, then the air unit. All these are connected to your ThingsWorx platform using the sensors. I mean, there is a connectivity. ThingsWorx connection server is responsible for the flow of the data from these devices to the ThingsWorx platform. As you can see, I can see the temperature, the airflow, the noise level, indoor noise level, and the outdoor noise level in the real time. I mean, the data that you see is basically the real time data. Now, for example, I need to look for some other unit, okay, the roof air top. Then, as I said, you can see the temperature. Like for the previous asset, the temperature was like 165 Fahrenheit. In this, it is like 220 Fahrenheit. So based on that, I can take an action. This is the data that is actually coming in real time. So this is actually empowering me, empowering my workforce, empowering my technicians to take quick actions. I mean, the building owner, or the person who is responsible for this asset, can actually take quick actions. So how that can be done is that I can contact the owner of this particular building, say contact owner. The moment I click on contact owner, a dialog box will open up for me, wherein all the key information will be opened up, like the phone, fax, and whatever, all the required details. I also can schedule a service for this. Once I have contacted owner, what I can do is that scheduling a service. Once I click the schedule service type, I can select the service, I can select the date, then I can submit request. Another good thing about this ThingsWorx platform is that you have this ability to remotely monitor your device and manage your device. I mean, you can manage your devices remotely from the dashboard. Okay, just imagine like how it is empowering yourself. I mean, the complete workforce. And I mean, there's no need for a human being or for an individual or for a service technician to go to the site physically and adjust the temperature. I mean, you can sit kilometers of distance away and you are able to monitor the temperature and manage the temperature. These, what you see over here, like it's are basically components of the smart cities also. And smart cities has been a quite hot topic out there, and people are highly interested in the smart cities. So ThingsWorx platform is actually one of the best platforms that you can have deployed for your smart cities, to manage your smart cities. Okay, no matter what assets you have, whether it be a dustbin, whether it be parking, whether it be light, whatever assets you have, it can be connected to the ThingsWorx platform. Now, coming back to this dashboard, as I was talking previously, it also helps you to adjust the temperature. The moment I click it, okay, I have got my various floors. I can remotely control the temperature sitting kilometers away from that building. Okay, then I also have an access to, I can access to my lighting areas. I can remotely control the lighting of my building, for example. And all this is being done using the ThingsWorx platform. I mean, there is no other tool or no other extra third-party system that is being deployed to control your assets. All your assets are being controlled through a single platform. Okay. Now, this is the main hall area. So, what I can do is that using this dashboard, I can control it. I can switch the light on. So, I just want you to imagine how it is empowering yourself, how it is empowering the workforce, how it is increasing the productivity. Then in this particular slide, what I see is that what is the energy consumption, power consumption, what is the weekly energy consumption, the weekly power consumption. Okay, I can integrate this ThingsWorx platform with my meters, okay, to understand the energy usage. And talking on another level, these can also be integrated with the outside weather component to actually understand the energy usage or the future energy usage based on the temperature that you have outside. For example, once I connect this to my weather, live weather report, I can predict, I mean, what will be the energy usage in the next 1 day or 2 day, or I can say that the next energy usage within the next 6 hours based on the current weather scenario. Then again, I also have this ability to predict the cost of my energy consumptions, like what has been the energy consumption for the last 3 months, 6 months, 2 months, 1 month, based on that and using some other factors and parameters like the weather, I can predict what my cost is going to be in the next month or within the next year. So as you can see, the predicted cost in this example has been like 36K. So based on that, I took some measures, and because of which I was able to reduce my cost. So basically, this actually helps with the proactive maintenance. It basically helps you with the proactive maintenance of your assets. Okay, no matter what assets you have, so to summarize all this up, ThingsWorx is basically a platform wherein you are connecting your assets, your devices, no matter what data sources they are coming from, whether they be from industries, whether they be from factories, from healthcare sector, from oil and gas, or be a device as simple as your laptop or your iPhone. All the data from these devices can be connected to the ThingsWorx platform. Okay, fine. Once you connect all this data to the ThingsWorx platform, what you can do is that you can model your data by connecting, by matching up your data. You can define your business rules. Once you define your business rules, you can create dashboards or apps on top of that, okay, to monitor your applications, to control your applications. So that's pretty much it from my side with regards to the PTC platform. Okay, so that's it from with regards to the PTC platform from my side. So let's look if we have any questions coming in.
Yes, Sohail, we can hear you.
Yeah, Chanakya, I'm done with the presentation.
All right, okay, Sohail. Thank you so much, Sohail.
Okay, thank you.